Hello and welcome to another video. Today, after such a long time you guys have been wanting this, we are going to look around Ant's coffee shop with Ant. So let's walk in and let's say hi. Hello, Ant.
Hello, sir. What would you like today?
I want an iced coffee. Give me an iced coffee.
Okay, hit the button.
I have to press the button myself. What kind of service is this? Right, I press the button. Coffee powder low. So let's, okay, explain to me what's going on here.
Right now, there's some machines downstairs that are making your drink for you.
Sweet. So it's coming up on the monitor?
The monitor?
The monitor on Computer Craft. It's grinding more fresh beans. Is it going to do that quickly?
I'm not sure if it's broken.
Oh, God, that would be a good start to the video. Let's go have a look downstairs. So, wow, this is... I don't know where to start, so you're just going to have to explain going round, like, from the start.
It's so big, I've forgotten some bits myself, but I'll do the best I can.
Right, okay.
Okay, the start, let's say we start over here. We have two chests that store some mugs and the coffee beans. The coffee beans, I don't really know how you actually make the coffee beans, I just spawn those in.
I've been actually trying to learn this with James, he's been, like, my teacher for this, and you have to kind of crossbreed plants.
Yeah.
And it's completely random how it works.
Yeah, I wanted to make it all fully automated, like having it growing coffee beans itself. Yeah. But I have no idea how you do that.
Yeah, I don't think it's possible. The amount of time it takes to get coffee beans is really just not a viable thing.
So apart from the beans, the mugs, there's a machine on the other side of this room that's making mugs.
All right. Oh, so it's all scattered everywhere.
Yeah, and also there's a cow out the back where we get the milk from.
Okay, let's go have a look. The back.
So we've got the charging
for the blue tricity. That's at the back as well, isn't it?
Okay.
You've got two solar panels, but that's not blue tricity. No, the blue tricity is on the roof.
Yeah, there's blue tricity and there's also what do you call it? Industrial craft.
Yeah.
Industrial craft is these two on the ground and blue tricity is on the roof.
Yeah. So we've got
our cow.
Yeah, so he's being milked.
We never actually named the cow. Should we name the cow?
Give him a name.
Moo face.
Moo face it is. Moo faster. That would
do. If he didn't want to get milked, he should have moved faster.
Oh, I wish I knew what that was from.
It's from The Lion King.
Oh. Why don't I know these things? I don't know anything. I think he's escaping.
Did you push the cow out the...
I didn't mean to. I didn't think he can climb up a fence. Get there.
Get back in there, Moo face.
So this is a deployer.
It deploys a bucket onto the cow.
And then it picks up the milk and then it sucks the milk back down into the machines down below.
Yeah.
So let's go walk downstairs. There's actually nothing upstairs, I should point out. The upstairs is automated night lights set up with a day and night sensor. If you want to know how to make a day and night sensor, click the annotation below. But let's go downstairs again. So where we get up to? So we have...
Let's go back over to this corner.
Right, okay. Where are you? Okay, there you are. Right, so what does this do here?
So we've got the coffee beans from the chest over there, and it goes into a macerator, and macerates it into coffee powder.
Oh, okay.
And then that gets sucked out of the macerator into this here, which is an automatic crafting table.
Yeah, oh, okay.
Actually, it's a Mark II automatic crafting table. The difference is that the Mark II has an inventory and the 3x3 thingy for your recipe.
I see.
So you can load it up with ingredients and then it keeps churning out whatever you're making.
Right, okay. So it's also getting the water from the water bucket. Where's the water bucket?
The water is over this corner.
Right.
And that's the same sort of deal as the cow. It's using a bucket in this deployer here.
Yeah, a deployer, and then it's shooting the filter out and into... Okay, I see. Yep.
So your water, your coffee powder, and your mugs are combined in this crafting table here.
Yep.
And then it gets sucked out into this chest.
Right, so that's using Billcraft sucked out in then.
Yeah, I think there was an issue using Redpower to get it to come out.
Oh, okay. Because it's crafting table too. It's not a real...
Yeah, the crafting table is a bit dodgy.
I think that is actually related to Billcraft more than Redpower. So, yeah.
Really?
Yeah. What on earth is going on?
That's what I get for doing voiceovers in my nice room. Instead of out of my deck.
Oh, yeah, because you live by a road. So we got this These two, I can't right click on them, so I don't know what they are.
These are just filters to get it from the chest. The reason it comes out and goes into a chest instead of just going onto somewhere is that we want to decide which way to send it from here, depending on what was ordered.
Right.
So if what we're calling an iced coffee is ordered, which is actually just the cold coffee in industrial craft,
yeah,
then one of these filters will get activated, then it'll suck it out and go out to the hole that shoots it to the customer.
Oh, it goes through one of these high-speed things.
Yeah, these are, I think called mag.
Oh, we've got an electric furnace. This must be the cooker one.
Like, yeah, the hot. So if it wasn't an iced coffee, it goes this other route over here to the furnace.
Oh, I see, and then it just goes straight out to the customer, which is that hole here.
Mm-hmm.
So where's the... There's three types, isn't there?
Well, there's cold coffee, there's hot coffee, I think it's called, or just coffee.
Yeah.
And then there's white coffee. So if it's hot coffee or white coffee, it has to be heated in the furnace first. So those come over here to the furnace.
Yeah, that's the electric furnace. Yeah.
It's a industrial craft electric furnace.
You've got some upgrades in there. I don't understand what these upgrades are.
I think this is James is doing. He's the genius about this bit. Basically just makes it run faster.
Oh, okay.
Putting upgrades into the furnace.
Right, I see.
Let me come around because I'm a bit stuck by these pipes.
Yeah, I know. It's really hard to move around in here. What's this out here?
Out here, this
used
is...
Used milk bucket return.
This is the cow milking machine.
Oh, okay, so the cow's above
that
there.
That thing in the ceiling is the depoy that's underneath the cow.
Oh, I see. So it retrieves the milk, and then it shoots the milk down into... Okay, there's another crafting table here. Dark coffee, sugar, and milk.
Hang on, if we go back to the furnace a second. When it comes out of the furnace, it's the same deal as when it comes out of the crafting table. Basically,
right.
If they wanted coffee... just coffee and not white coffee, then it comes out and gets sent up to the customer.
Oh, it goes, yep.
Then if not, then it goes over to this other crafting table.
Which is all for milky
and
tea.
This adds water and sugar to the coffee to turn it into white coffee.
Well, milk and dark.
Oh yeah, milk and sugar, yeah. Sorry.
To make milky tea.
Yeah.
Milky
and then
coffee.
Tea, this ain't no tea shop.
Milk and coffee. And then
it comes
up
out
to the...
up the thing. Now, we did forget a rather important part of the whole process, which is that this is all controlled by a computer.
Yep, because this would be a lot bigger if this was all done in Redpower.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So those three buttons at the top, they come down and there's a program running on the computer that it's basically waiting for the button to be pressed. And once it's pressed, it starts the sequence.
Yeah.
And there's a couple of item detectors and stuff around the room, and they say where the coffee is at the moment, and from that the computer decides what to do next.
Okay, well at the moment it's stuck, isn't it? There's coffee powder low grinding more fresh beans.
Yeah, I'm not sure what's happened here, because if we see in the macerator, there's actually some coffee powder stuck in the macerator.
Right, so if you take that out.
If I take that out and put it over into the
coffee powder lights is turned on, it's going to bring some more coffee beans round. So it's macerated them. It's not sucking it out, I don't think. Or is it?
Something's gone wrong over here.
Oh, so it's actually come up with another... So this has been a while since you've actually...
Yeah,
you built this ages ago, and we've only just got around to doing the video for it. So it's actually
the problem is that the filter next to the macerator isn't being triggered for some reason.
There's also... Oh, there's more stuff down here. Okay, let's... what's down here? I think these are just... Is this just to tidy it up?
These are just... to keep the wires out of the way as much as possible.
Yeah.
So that we have more space to have some crap up the top.
Yeah, I see. So it looks like, looking in here, there's no water bucket going in.
Ah, maybe that's the problem.
Yeah.
If we look at the crafting table, we've got powder and mugs in there, but no water.
Yes, I don't know how to... This is kind of... We're like debugging this as we're walking through the video.
What does this pipe do?
I don't know. You're supposed to tell me.
Let's grab a torch and see what happens. A redstone torch.
Right. Oh, because these are all powered pipe.
Yeah, this is the same.
Oh, it's bringing a water bucket round. So it wasn't actually triggering it before. Okay, it's now made the tea, and it's now going to... Oh, the tea's
coffee,
now
the
going
coffee,
into
the
chest.
It's not tea.
The coffee's going into the chest. It's just shot into this one. It's exciting. I didn't really know what to look before, so now I actually know it's doing stuff. I don't know where it's gone now. Is it all popped out the top?
What was ordered? It was an iced coffee that you ordered.
It was an iced coffee, so I think it's just gone straight through. Yes, there we go. It's all popped out the top. Let's order something else now. So
that was some nice speedy service from Ant's Cafe.
let's get a black coffee because this takes longer to do. So let's tick that. So it's going to come order number 2. So it kind of it knows what numbers. So if we actually press more buttons.
If you press another button, it will wait until it's finished this one first. This screen, I don't know if you noticed downstairs, there was a modem attached to the side of the computer.
Yeah.
And the same script that controls all the machines is actually sending some messages on RedNet to another computer behind this monitor.
Oh, I see. And so then it outputs it on the monitor.
Yeah. One, that computer. Oh, your coffee's done. I stole it. There you go.
That's right. I've got an iced coffee. I've got 2 now.
Oh, I wanted it.
Have the iced coffee. So if we drink it, and get our speed boost. Woo! We've also got these chests. These are just for decoration, aren't they? Milk, sugar, napkins. Yeah. But also in the corner, we've got a please return empty mugs here.
So if you chuck a mug in there, it goes... Oh, we both missed.
it does. It detects from around, doesn't it? It sends like a redstone pulse to this machine. I don't know what the machine is. Let's go walk down.
I think it might have been a retriever.
Right.
Which, that one sucks up blocks in a certain radius when it gets a redstone signal.
Yeah, which is this bit here.
So those mugs get put back into the mugs chest back at the start.
So basically that little timer is going around and every time it ticks 3 seconds, it will suck up whatever's been chucked near the bin area. Mm-hmm. So I think when these are powered, these can actually pick up anything in a 3x3 area. So that's though you missed it, it still picked it up because it was in sort of like the radius of the block. That was something James taught me this. I'm slowly learning it all.
You talked about the hollow blocks in the last video.
Yeah.
And it can actually suck it up through a hollow block. It just won't accept it if you try and chuck it into something through a hollow block.
Yeah. Yeah, because the hollow block isn't hollow.
Yeah.
Yeah, but whereas this one, it just detects it on area, not like what's around it. So I'm guessing if you had like a block on top, you can completely probably hide one of these and it will still suck stuff up. I think that's how it works.
That might be worth a test.
How it works. And then it just goes straight through into this relay, which then goes down into this. Oh, I can't even get in the hole. Down through some buildcraft stuff. Oh, there's a lava down there. So I think, is that a filter for if it's not?
Yeah, it comes out the relay, which basically chucks out the item, and it's just as if you, gave Lex a cookie like that.
Yep.
And then there's a diamond pipe, and that splits. If it's a stone mug, it goes into the chest. If not, it goes into the lava.
Oh, I see. Oh, I'm stuck. I can't go through that way. I can't get out. Oh, there we go. So it goes back. Oh, I fell down. So it goes into
this
holder.
I'm not sure why it's here.
Well, yeah, there's holes everywhere. There's cables everywhere. It's really hard to move down here. But that's everything for the coffee shop, isn't it? We've covered everything here. Oh, there's some more stuff here. I don't know what this is.
This pipe just goes over and lights up this coffee powder out light, I think.
Oh, I see. So basically it detects... Gotcha. So that is it for this video. I know you guys have been wanting this for a long time. We finally got round to doing it. So now you should know how the coffee thing works. Before we finish, how do you get the coffee beans?
Dunno, ask James.
Okay then. Goodbye.
Bye.